गुड मॉर्निंग एंड जय हिंद स्टूडेंट्स. हेयर आई एम विद द चैप्टर द रेड ट्रैप फ्रॉम द बुक फ्लेमिंगो. एंड हेयर द ओल्ड मैन वॉज जस्ट एज जनरस विद हिज कॉन्फिडेंसेज एज विद हिज पॉरिज एंड टोबैको. सो ही वॉज वेरी काइंड पर्सन एंड ही सर्व्ड पॉरिज एंड टोबैको. एंड द गेस्ट वॉज इन्फॉर्म्ड एट वंस दैट इन हिज डेज ऑफ प्रॉस्पेरिटी हिज होस्ट हैड बीन अ means the old man was an iron worker at Ram's jo iron works mill and had worked on the land also. So now that he was no longer able to do day labor, so he had kept cows and he would sell cow milk to earn money. The stranger must have seemed incredulous. Incredulous means that you can't believe. For the old man got up and went to the window, took down. और उसने ये भी बताया कि he had received all of 30 kroner in payment. But stranger यानी जो peddler था उसको believe नहीं हुआ. Then the old man had taken and then showed him that this amount is here. These he held before the eyes of the guest, nodding knowingly, and then he showed to his guest that 30 kroner, and then the guest means the peddler was surprised. And the next day means both they slept. Next day both men got up in good season. The crofter was in a hurry to milk his cow, because crofter was hurry to milk his cow, and then he had gone and he milked his cow and he went to sell his cow milk. And the rat trap seller, he also thanked him and he went to his own way. But half an hour later, the rat trap peddler stood again before the door. He didn't try to get in, however. He only went up to the window because he was thinking about the 30 kroner, about the money. So he went back to the house and he tried to get in, but he could not because it was locked. So he just put his hand inside and smashed a pan, and in this way he was able to move in his hand and got hold of the pouch with money. So then he took out the money and he placed the leather pouch at the same place. Then he moved. As he walked alone with the money in his pocket, he felt quite pleased with his smartness. He was thinking that easily he had got the money and he is becoming rich now, and this amount is enough for his living for so many days. And he went into a dense forest. It was a path with twisted back and forth. From where he would start his journey, he would come to the same place. Means he was not able to come out from that forest. It was so dense and he was trapped there. Then he came to a place where, and it was December and it was full chilled night, and he was full of gloom and despair. He was thinking that his end was near, and at the moment he sat down on the ground being hopeless. Then suddenly he heard a sound, a hard regular thumping, and it was done by a hammer. So those are the hammer strokes from an iron mill, he thought. There must be people near by. He summoned all his strength and he moved to the sound. The Ramsjo iron works was there, mill was there, and which are now closed down in nowadays. It has been closed down, were not so long ago a large plant with the smelter, rolling mill and forge in the summer time. In the summer time, long lines of heavily loaded barges and scows slide down the canal. It is about the previous time of that mill when it was working. Now roads near and roads were full of black powder due to coal dust. So during one of the long dark evenings, just before Christmas, the master smith and his helper sat in the means when he reached there, then these people, they were sitting there large near the furnace. Furnace means angithi hota. They were waiting for the pig iron which had been put on the fire to be ready to put on the anvil. So every now and then one of them got up to the stir to the glowing mass with a long iron bar. They were stirring it, returning in a few moments dripping with perspiration, means sweating, though as was the custom, he wore nothing but a long shirt and a pair of wooden shoes. All the time there were many sounds to be heard in the forge. The big bellows groaned because when it is something means coal or any burn is there, then it when it is in a speed, it makes a sound. So it was there. The fire boy shoveled charcoal into the maw of the furnace with a great deal of clatter, and he put these charcoal there with clattering sound. Outside road, the waterfall was there outside, and a sharp north wind whipped the rain against the brick tiled roof. It was raining and wind was moving. Okay students, I will start in my next video. Till then, Jai Hind.